Well, we know eating healthy is important, but it's harder for some people who don't have access to nutritious foods. And Treasure Roberts joins me now. She has a special report on the grocery gap here in Peoria coming up tonight. But Treasure, first of all, explain to us, what is a grocery gap?
Alrighty, so a grocery gap is essentially a food desert. Now, that's an area that has limited access to nutritious and, of course, affordable food. Now, there's different ranges. If you live in a suburban area or you live in an urban area, if you are 1 mile from a supermarket, then you live in a food desert. But if you live in a rural area and you're 10 miles from a supermarket, then you live in a food desert.
And we know we have a lot of both of those kinds of areas in central Illinois, both urban and rural. So how is it affecting neighbors specifically here in Peoria?
It is really affecting them. As you know, healthy foods are very important. Fresh produce, fruits, vegetables. Everyone who's anyone needs those things. So the people who don't live as close to supermarkets aren't able to get the foods they need because sometimes they settle going to the places that are easier to get to. A lot of times, food deserts are in low-income neighborhoods. They have less mobility. So think about it. If you can get in your car and drive to the nearest supermarket, which may be 15 to 20 minutes away, that might be easy for you. But some people can't get there as easy if you have to walk, if you have to take the bus. So that's how it's definitely impacting a lot of people in the Peoria area.
And this being said, we know that some people are working on solutions to this problem. So kind of tell us what community leaders are doing to help the people most affected by this.
So community leaders are in the works or in a process of actually trying to gain business owners within the community who are interested in opening up these type of markets or shops where people can sell healthy foods in these neighborhoods that don't have them. But alongside the city leaders, the community leaders are also doing a lot right now. The Southside Community United for Change has actually opened up a Southside Farmers Market that's open every Saturday. So they have one on November 16th, which is this Saturday, and November 23rd from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Well, they'll offer fruits and vegetables, fresh, might I add, and they're also offering jobs. So I think that this is amazing. There are two more times for the farmers market before the end of the year. So definitely, if you have not taken advantage of it, I highly suggest you take advantage of it.
Now, we mentioned you do have a special report coming up tonight.
Yes.
At 10 o'clock.
Yes, yes.
And you have spoken with some of those community leaders who are working on solutions. You've also spoken with the people who are directly affected by this, correct?
Yes, yes.
All right, we're definitely going to want to hear from them. Again, that's coming up tonight. Tonight at 10 o'clock right here on WMVD. Treasure, thank you so much. We'll look forward to that. More news right after the break.